Hello all, my name is Harri Mättä, and in this video I'm going to give a short introduction to PrinLab's roll-to-roll machine. PrinLab's roll-to-roll machine is a small-scale R&D and manufacturing machine. Small-scale means that it is really compact, and in that way it's easy to use, and we don't have to use that much material on the testing and on the manufacturing. The machine is actually only a bit more than 2 meters long, and the web width is 80 millimeters. The small scale means that whenever we are testing different materials, we are able to use only small amount of material. So we don't have to use too much of expensive materials, but only small amount is enough. Let's now go deeper into the configuration of our machine. The printing process is started by putting an empty roll of substrate here at the unbinder. From the unbinder, the substrate is guided through the different parts of the machine all the way to the rewinder. At the unwinder, the important thing is to make sure that we have the diameter measurement rod touching this substrate. By measuring the diameter, we can control the break in this unwinder. And by controlling the break, we can make sure that the tension of the web stays constant throughout the print. First parts of the machine, even before the first printing units, are a plasma treatment unit, which can be used to clean or change the surface properties of the substrate. Then we have the tension meter, which is actually measuring the tension of the web. And then we have the web guidance system. With this guidance system, we are able to control the direction of the web in the X direction. Printing units are located here. First, we have the flexo printing unit. Then we have a gravure printing unit. We have also hot embossing unit here. And on the second floor, we have the rotary screen unit. After the printing units, we have our oven here. And in this case, this is a hot air oven. After the oven, we have a web guidance system, so that we are making sure that the rewinding is done properly. And after rewinding, the web is ready for second round of prints. The so-called drive nib is here, at the end of the machine. This is actually setting the web speed that we are running. After the drive nib, we have the rewinder, and after all the prints and processes that we have done, the web, the substrate, is being rewinded here. And after that, it is ready for post-processing or the next step on the printing process. Now, we are going to go deeper into the different printing methods that we have here on our roll-to-roll machine.
This is a flexo printing unit. Flexo printing consists of a anilox roll, which is actually rotating in a reservoir of ink. From that reservoir, the analog roll is taking the ink into itself. Here we have a blade, doctor blade, which is removing the excess ink out of the analog roll. So after the doctor blade has removed all the excess ink, there is only ink in the small holes of the analog roll. Those small holes are actually engraved into the surface of the roll using an engraver, in some cases laser. It's a steel plate with copper on top of it, and the engravings are done on the copper surface. After that, there is a chromium plating to make it more durable. So the ink is transferred from the analog roll to the printing plate, the flexo plate here on this nib. The nib is now open. From the flexo plate, the ink is being transferred into the substrate, which is going through here in this nib. Printing plate at flexo printing is made out of rubber or plastic. The plate is where you have your layout that you're going to print. As you can see, the structure is so that the image that you want to print on the substrate is actually raised from the surface of the plate. So this is the image that you want to print, and this is the surface of the rubber plate. It's been attached to this steel plate using double-sided tape. The counter roll in flexo printing unit is made out of steel. This is gravure printing unit. This is the most simplest one when it comes to moving parts of a system. So basically, we have here the printing plate, which is actually pretty much the same as in flexo printing unit, the analog plate. So this is a steel plate with a thin layer of copper, where you have the engravings of the layout that you want to print. And after that, it has been coated with chromium. The ink is being put onto the doctor plate using, for example, a tool like this, or whatever pipette you want to use. The ink is being put here, and then we adjust so that the doctor plate is actually removing again the excess ink from the surface of the plate, but only on the engravings you have the ink on the layout. If there's some excess ink flowing on the sides, there is a reservoir for that. In certain cases, if we have for example, solvent-based ink, and the solvent is vaporizing quickly, and there's a risk that we might have to stop the process too early because of the vaporized solvent, we can use this type of chamber-like doctor plate system. So this will be attached here. The doctor plates, the blade is inside, and from here we can insert the ink. And because of the closed structure, the solvent in the ink is not able to vaporize that much. counter roll in gravure printing unit is actually soft. This is so-called hot embossing unit. It can also be called nano imprint lithography unit. The idea is that we have a thin sleeve here on top of the steel plate where you have the structure or layout that you want to produce on the substrate. This is different from the other methods in a way that we are not actually adding any material on the substrate. We are just making the layout or the structure to the substrate using heat and pressure. In our unit here, we have the heating element inside the steel plate, so it will warm up the surface of the printing plate or the sleeve up to certain temperature that is needed for making the structure under the plastic. Counter roll in this unit is soft. Here we have a rotary screen unit. The rotary screen technology is actually pretty much the same as in tabletop screen printing. The main difference is of course that the screen is here in a cylinder form. The printing happens in this unit so that you have the rotary screen here. The squeegee is actually located inside the cylinder, and so is the ink that you are going to print. You might put the print using a pipette or using automated feeding system. Once you have the material inside and you are ready to print, you actually close the nib by using this, and then using automation you will do the actual squeegee pressure to the screen. The nib pressures of the machine can be adjusted. So the nibs that there are in the machine are between the anilux and the flexoplate, then between the flexoplate and the counter roll. On the gravure unit, you have one nib, so which is in between the gravure printing plate and the counter plate. In hot embossing, you have also one nib, and then you have the drive nib pressure. This is the control unit of the machine. From here, we can see different parameters of the process, and we can control the process. So starting from the upper row, we have here the rewinder tension adjustment. So what is the tension on the rewinding? We have then controls of the ovens. So we actually have a possibility to have a top oven and also the oven on downstairs. We can control the drive nib on and off, and we can see the temperatures of the ovens and hot embossing unit. Here is the main control of the web speed. Usually the printing speeds are different depending on what unit are we using, but in many cases the speeds are relatively low. We are talking about from 1 to 10 meters per minute. This is the main machine control screen here at the interface. From this user interface, we can control the machine settings. So we can start the machine, of course, stop the machine. Then we can set the settings for different units, flexor unit, gravure and hot embossing, and screen printing unit. From the settings, the main settings are enabling the unit whenever needed. Then the home position adjustment, which is actually something that we can do to adjust the Y direction on the unit. This setting can be done in quite high accuracy, so the Y axis accuracy can be very high. We can also set the speed for this actual unit. So the web speed is being controlled by the drive nib, and it's a separate adjustment. In this screen, we can adjust the flexo blade speed, which is different from the web speed. Gravure and hot embossing settings are pretty much the same as in flexo.
This was the short introduction to our World Roll machine. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us with email or by phone. Thank you.